Good evening. We're going to get this thing started. So welcome and thank you for joining us for Elsa Ford Instrumental Music Department's Spring Concert. This is our final primary concert of the year, and this year has been a wonderful year for us as a music department. Often the transition between directors can be very difficult, filled with drama and a lot of changes, but because of the wonderful students, parents, and staff that we have here, it's been a very easy transition for us. And I can say that truly every day has been a pleasure, and that's not the easiest thing to say in today's educational climate. So the students that have been incredibly busy this year, depending on the ensemble that they have participated in, they have performed anywhere, as of graduation in a few weeks, anywhere between 8 and 14 times. Just performances. Students have embraced many new activities beyond our normal busy schedule, including participating in Michigan Scholastic marching band competitions. We did a side-by-side football game with some 8th grade students. We did our first year of having a performing arts orientation in the fall to welcome all of our performing arts students here into the school. And then we even renewed and hosted and organized a Dearborn Band and Orchestra Festival where 8 schools from Dearborn schools came and were adjudicated based off their playing, all hosted and organized here at Edsel Ford. So even with juggling this heavy performance schedule, the students have shown tremendous musical growth, as I hope that you will realize. If you can take it back a second and think all the way back to the fall, what that sounded like, and I hope you'll hear the tremendous growth. I know that I do. Tonight's concert is also a celebration of our graduating seniors. These students have dedicated countless hours and time, both inside and out of school, to the Performing Arts Department. It is through their leadership and musical contributions that the path to now has been set, and that is set for our future students. Graduating seniors today are wearing flowers in recognition of their achievement. So first to perform today is our jazz ensemble, and this is our first of 2 sets, and this is our blues set, including Blues Walk, Blues Monk, and St. Louis Blues. Our soloist on the first one for Blues Walk is Jacob Gilman. On our second song, Blue Monk, we have Hope Kalito. And then finally, on St. Louis Blues, we have Sean Bryan. I hope you enjoy our first set of the Edsel Ford Jazz Ensemble. Thank you.
Thank you.
The passing of time is inevitable. Summer leads to fall, and winter, unfortunately this year, gave way to spring again. With each passing season, we get a little bit older, but within each of us, there's a flicker that remains of the spirit of our youth. The next set of music, as performed by the String Orchestra, celebrates the stories of our imaginations and the adventures of our childhood. With The Incredibles, we celebrate the young child that wants nothing more than to be a superhero. Where's that little shirt every day? Where's that cute? When our dreams and imaginations are a little too vivid, it is a mother's lullaby that calms us down to sleep. When you were a child, each day is a new legend ready to be written. Sometimes that story involves a swashbuckling pirate, but sometimes we're just musicians. So our music for today is, once again, The Incredibles and Lullaby, followed by Pirate's Legend. Thank you. Before we perform our final piece, I'm asking, will this year's graduating seniors from the orchestra please stand up and be recognized at this time? We will miss them. Please have best of luck and play your final piece with everything, right? So, ladies and gentlemen, with that being said, our final piece, Pirate's Legend.
Thank you.
Next up is our first senior soloist of the evening, Sean Bryan. Sean is a tremendous musical talent and has been an incredible asset to the band program, performing in marching band, symphonic band, paid orchestra, jazz ensemble, basically everything we have to offer here at EBSCoL. Sean demonstrates daily the qualities that it means to be a great student, including great character, responsibility, and passion. Today, he'll be performing for you a piece that he performed for Solon Ensemble Festival back in February, Minuet from the Hafner Music by Mozart. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you enjoy Sean Bryan.
Thank you.
Our final part of our first half of the concert is our second jazz ensemble set. For our second set, we decided to do a little bit of a Latin flavor, but not exactly the fiery, fast pieces that come to mind when we think of Latin flavors. For this side, we are going to explore a little bit of a softer side, thinking of a little bit of that tropical seaside vacation. We might have programmed this in February when we wanted to escape. So our first song is going to be Girl from Ipanema, which stars at the beginning Jacob Gilman and Emma Alvey in a saxophone duet. Then our second song will be The One Note Samba by Novak. Hope you enjoy.
Thank you. gonna have the concert in 10 minutes.
So starting our second half, I'm very happy to have the two performers that you see on stage, Hezekiah Turner and Katrina Stano. This year they performed a wonderful partnership. This is Hezekiah's first year in the orchestra here at Edsel, even though he's a junior, but he has been a fantastic asset, and him and Katrina played marvelously from the first second that they sat together. Their song, Album Leaf, earned them a superior rating at the District Soul Ensemble Solo Festival, and they were able to take it to compete at the state level back in March. They both have tremendous talent. It's been a supreme pleasure to hear this piece, as well as all of their music, progress over the last year. Ladies and gentlemen, on viola, Hezekiah Turner, and on violin, Katrina Stano playing Album Leaf. For anyone that has opened their ear to the news even a tiny bit, they would know that the last year has been a tumultuous year for the United States, filled with racial and cultural tensions. In recognition of the world around us this evening, the Symphonic Band celebrates diversity with its program. George Washington, Martin Luther King, Abraham Lincoln, Harriet Tubman, and Susan B. Anthony. These are but a few of the names that are celebrated in history for their contributions to our foundations in liberty, equality, and justice as we strive to live in today. For each name that is celebrated in history, however, there are countless more that go unrecognized. They are our unsung heroes. In April, we celebrated the 150th anniversary of the ending of the Civil War. The piece that you're about to hear, Last Full Measure, is written in memorial of the Battle of Gettysburg, which is the bloodiest battle of the war. In our final piece, we jump to the 1960s Baltimore with selections from the musical Hairspray, a social commentary on the injustices in parts of American society in the 60s. 50 years later, it's interesting that Baltimore once again has become the center for America's fight for equality and social justice. Please sit back and enjoy as Edsel Ford High School Symphonic Band celebrates our unsung heroes. Thank you. Before we perform our final piece, can we please have our beloved band seniors please stand up and be recognized at this time for your contributions? This is what we call a good year because we're not losing many. We never like losing them. So thank you again for all of your hard work and dedication. All three of you have been fantastic contributions. I'm glad I had you in my first year. Thank you again. And now, selections from Hairspray.
Thank you.
Our final soloist of the evening is Michael Nelson. Though I've not had the privilege of having Michael for one of my actual scheduled classes on my roster, I've had the privilege of working with him in both marching band and as part of our jazz ensemble. A strong independent musician, Michael's choice, Brahms Rhapsody No. 2, is a fantastic demonstration of both his musical skills and the vibrancy that he brings to the performing arts. It's been a pleasure having him for this year, and performing for you now, Brahms Rhapsody No. 2, Opus 79, is Michael Nelson.
Thank you.
This is the final chapter in today's book. So our final piece of the evening is called Engines of Resistance by Larry Clark. Our seniors will soon be entering a new chapter of their lives and will inevitably encounter challenges along the path with, if I can read my mind, will inevitably encounter challenges on the path. It is our sincerest hope that they embrace these with their strength to manage the challenges that they face, fighting the engines of resistance and living the fullest of lives. At this time, graduating seniors, may you please stand one last time and be recognized as a whole group. Ladies and gentlemen, Engines of Resistance. Thank you.